What are forever chemicals and where are they found? Well, as you may suspect, forever chemicals are something that can stay in your body for a very long time and they don't break down readily. Now, one of the things is that they bioaccumulate. So what that means is that our organs don't necessarily detoxify and eliminate these forever chemicals very readily. And it's something that we really have to think about, our exposure to the forever chemicals. Most recently in California, they actually banned the forever chemicals in food packaging and in children's products. So this will come into full effect in July of 2023. It is currently being phased out. So that is good news, and the awareness around the forever chemicals, known as PFASs, this is something that is promising, but I definitely think that we need to do our due diligence and learn more about how we can avoid this exposure, and more importantly, how to detoxify the forever chemicals from our bodies. So some of the most common places that you will find these forever chemicals are in fast food containers. So you know, if you've probably seen this before, if it sort of has a waxy, shiny looking coating on the inside of that takeaway container, this could be the forever chemicals, the PFASs, as well as pizza boxes are known to have these chemicals. Microwave popcorn bags, we know that microwave popcorn usually isn't the healthiest way to go in terms of popcorn, but specifically if it's a microwavable bag that comes, you know, commercially processed, this is definitely containing those PFASs as well. We also have to be aware of candy wrappers. So candy, yeah, because the sugar not so good, but the wrappers themselves can be toxic. Nonstick cookware is known to have these PFASs, as well as stain resistant coating. So whether this is in carpets, it could be in upholstery and other fabrics, could contain these forever chemicals as well. As well as water-resistant clothing. So for kids' sleepwear, this is very common, so you have to watch the labels for this, as well as paints, pesticides, even shampoo can have these forever chemicals, and even sunscreen. So this has been in the news most recently, something to be aware of in terms of the type of, if you do use sunscreen. I've got other videos about the healthy benefits of the sun, so make sure you check that out. If you are using sunscreen, make sure it's free of chemicals, so, and especially the forever chemicals. So today I talked all about forever chemicals and some of the most common places that you may find them. I hope you have questions or comments. Drop it in the comment section below. Be sure to share this video as well. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I hope that you'll subscribe and turn on those post notifications by clicking that bell. Now, everybody does have a calling in life, and mine is to empower you to live a healthy lifestyle and, of course, to do it naturally. Thanks for watching today.